So last class where we have completed our discussion is different kind of list, that is different kind of linked list. See, a list of items can be implemented either using the concept of array or by using the concept of pointers. If you go for implementing using the concept of pointers, then there are three, then that concept is going to be called as linked list. In that, there are three categories. One is single linked list, second one is circular linked list, and third one is double linked list. So in single linked list, you have nodes and the nodes are connected by links. And in double linked list also the same thing, circular linked list also the same thing. But the thing is, in the single linked list, you have ground, that is the last node is treated as the address of the last node is treated as null. Whereas here, the address is pointed to the first node. See, this is bring back here, right? Whereas in the double linked list, you have two arrow lines, one arrow lines from A to B and B to C, and another arrow lines in the backward direction, C to B and C to A, like that. So here also you have a header and as well as a type. So here there is one more node in order to understand this is the last node. So you have a type. So here also you can have, in double linked list also you can have, what is that? If you use the arrow here like that, and if you use the arrow here like that, then it is circular double linked list. So single, even though this is set as a circular linked list, this is a single circular linked list. If you have connection here, then it is a double circular linked list. So that is the idea here. So what I are going to do, what I are going to discuss then is ADT. So instead of studying the ADT, see, I already told that whenever you study a data structure, you should understand first the concept. Then the ADT. ADT should be dealt with severe various operations. So before getting into the ADT, since the subject is also associated with the lab component, I always encourage you to go through the programs. So if you go through the programs, if you write the programs either partially correct or in the pseudocode form, what is that? Then that is the one which is meant for theory exam as ADT. And if you write the program exactly without any errors in the computer, then that program may be treated as a lab program. So what I always suggest to students is, in one topic, you can gain profit for two subjects. One is lab as well as another is theory subjects. So what is the thing we are going to discuss is ADT, that is in the form of program. And here we are going to discuss about various operations of single linked list. So first the operation, what we are going to see, creation operation. And then we are going to see traversing, or we may say that searching, right? So this is the header file, you know that, you need to include it. And this is the one you need to remember always, that is the structure that is created for node. Once this portion is executed, what you will create it every time? A node is created, structure node, right? A node is created. This is the node. This is the node. And in that node is divided into two parts. One is data part. Another one is next pointer. Another one is next pointer. So data part as well as next pointer is the one which is hold for creating any node. And this method is meant for printing the list. So here the null pointer is checked until null pointer. See, you have to go and see if it has n number of nodes, so that n number of nodes will be checked one by one until the null node. So if the null node is there, so every time it is, whether how it is incremented, n equal to n tends to next, like that way. So one by one it is getting incremented, one node by node. So until if you find a node, that node address pointer is null. That node address pointer is null. So that case, that the situation is integer main, that is main program start. So you have created the head node, the second node, third node. That means your output should be first node, that is treated as a head node, and the second node as well as a third node. So what is the output is going to be? This is one, this is data into bar, and there will be a connection between them. There will be a connection. So that's way you are going to create the node. So there are some assignments submitted by the students, that is your regular students, you can go through the assignment question as well as the answer posted by the student. Then you can find a very good idea about what that coding is all about and what is it saying. So here this three statement is used to allocate memory. Allocate memory. And this particular set of statement is used to create the node. First data node is created and inside the data one is inserted. And the second data would address is the second data. So what is the output here is, let me redraw again. When you execute this code, what is the output is? According to that statement, so what will be the output and how the print list get executed is, what is that the thing that is given here? One node. Sorry, it is not coming up properly. So this is head node. So head node has data field and address field. So the data field contains two, right? One. And this address field points to second, right? Head of next. This node is treated as head. So this head of next, head of data, you have one, head of next equal to second node. So you have connection to second node, right? So that is the second node. So in that second node, the data field is number two is assigned, and that next is pointed to third. So third data is there, and the third next null. So this is what the linked list is created. And every time you are incrementing it in order to print the list. So what is the output of this program? 1, 2, 3, that's it. Number one is stored in one node. That node is a head node. Number two is stored in another node. That node is a second node. Number three is stored in another node. That node is third node. So that idea will be working out here. That is the idea that is working out here, right? What else then? So that's all about creation and traversing of single linked list. Now come to insertion, very, very important one. So after the creating and printing any data structure, you need to discuss about operation. With respect to single list, insertion, deletion, searching. That's the three operation. With respect to insertion, you have in what position you are inserting the element, whether insertion is at the beginning or insertion at the end, or insertion at any location, that is the situation. Likewise, if deletion is also deletion at the beginning, deletion at the end, deletion at any location. But here the code gives is deletion in any location. And finally, all the things put together, that is a complete routine, main routine for the single list. That's what we are going to see. So insertion at the beginning. So insertion at the beginning is, see, assume that this is the already available linked list, that is, this is the head node. The head node contains the data set 20 and it is pointing to the next node. The next node is having data 30 and it is null node, right? And it is null, this address field is null. So now what you want to insert is, you want to insert data 10, and that data should be inserted in the beginning. So how the code will look like? So add at the beginning the name of the method, and it accepts the argument. So the argument is item 10. So item, integer item, so 10 is passed here. So node star ptr, a node is created, that is a node is created, that is this box is created, in that has allotted some memory, that is allotted, and pointer of info is the item. So this is the info field or data field, order it may be. So here it is assigned to the item. So what is the item? It is passed 10 is passed, so 10 is assigned here. And then what is that? If start equal to null, so if the start equal to null, so this previously this was the start node. If that node is equal to null, then the pointer of next equal to null, or the pointer of next equal to start. So likewise, you have to make adjustment of connections with respect to the condition. And then you have to return the linked list. In that linked list, the item that is passed as the argument should be attached to the first node. So that is the idea here. So the pointer to the next, so where is the pointer? See, pointer is this new, the pointer to the next is null. then you have to take the condition. Otherwise, if the pointer turns equal to, you have to start the condition. So this is, you have to make the arrow, and this head you have made it to the point it to the this row. So that is there. Now come to insertion at the end. So in the end portion, in the end, that is in the last position, how the data is inserted, in what way the data is inserted, that is what you have to think. So add at the end, add at the end. So here already you have a linked list, already you have a linked list. The linked list is having some train, a number of items, certain number of items, and you are going to insert item 30. That 30 should be inserted at the end. So this is the starting node, and this is the next node, and this may be treated as a head node also, starting node also. So here, what you have to do, you have to create a pointer, and the pointer is allotted some memory, and the pointer info is added item 30, and the pointer next is added as null. So this is one node. So right. So if start equal to null, in case start equal, if start equal to null. So what is that start equal to null? In case the starting node is null, then the start equal to PTR, you have to mention. Otherwise, you have to create a temporary node. In that temporary node, you have to assign the data as well as the value and that address field, and then you have to mark the point to the value. That is the idea here. This is going to the temp. So this is insertion at the end. Next, insertion in any location. So if you want to insert the data at any location, say for example, this is the list, this is the list, and in that list you have to insert the item in the middle. In order to address in insert the item in the middle, what you can do is, so you can just get that link at the list. Just you have to go through the list value by value, one by one, and it has to find a suitable location in which insertion has to be carried out. And based upon the position, you have to make certain pointer adjustment. So if that is the node, that is the place where this node has to be attached, then what you can do is you can make a pointer adjustment. This pointer should make to point to this node, and this pointer, this next field should point to the this node. That is, it's like an insertion. It's like an insertion, but the insertion is detected in the middle or in any location. So how the code is supporting? The code is supporting the first, this set of code. This set of code is used to identify the position in which the given node has to be inserted. After identifying the position, so then by using the MLog method, then by using the ordinary C pointer method, the node is inserted accordingly. So this is what the output of the node in a pictorial form, in a pictorial form. Next, deletion in this area. So deletion, see here, there is a linked list. Here, there is a linked list. And here in this linked list, you want to delete C. If you want to delete C, what are you going to do? So only the C node is deleted. If that means that links is also get deleted. That is the link that is attached to it. The link that is going out of that node is get affected. So if it gets affected, the entire process is also affected. So what you can do is you have to do some pointer adjustment. So this pointer should point to this node, and you have to remove this temporary value. So how the logic look like, logic is working. So we are creating the two node. One is pointer node. Another one is a temp node, and you are getting the item value. After getting the item value, you are checking whether that start node is null or not. So if it is null, then you have to print what is that? The list is empty. No more deletion is possible. In case if the list is not empty, what you're going to do is with the help of a temp variable, the pointer that is needed to be removed as pointed out. When pointer not equal to null, if that pointer is not equal to null, if the pointer of info, the pointer of info of item is equal to temp of. So that is, you are making this pointer of info, making this point to make to this pointer, and you are simply returning the variable. That is, the returning this variable into a garbage. So that is the idea that is given here in order for a deletion in single linked list. Now putting it all together, the main program contains a set of print statement which is used to display like a choice. So you have to select any one choice, and accordingly the corresponding block will get executed. So if you say, for example, if it chooses a choice 3, choice 3 means then that choice 3 will check. So in this position, the choice 3 will be checking the value, and it is saying that based on the position and item where you have to insert accordingly. So what is that 4? What is that 3? It is an insert element at a given position, and that corresponding routine, see if the corresponding routine is this one. So this position is calling. So what is the duty of the main function? The main function will get the choice,
accordingly the corresponding switch case will executed and the switch case will call the corresponding function. This is what we came to know from the node. But actually what it happened is it is the node that is making itself to be that particular purpose, and the calling is carried out accordingly. So this is the one which is for secure. Yeah, yes. Where structure with the letter file, the node is created. The type directive store, likewise, this, and this concept is called referential structure. So this is display, how to display. See, this umptil routine is not new, and it is, we have already discussed it in the way in which before we explain the single list. The same procedure you will be going to follow the case of a double linked list. See, what is the difference between single linked list and double linked list? The main difference is number of links. So in single, you have only one link. In double link, you have two links. One is forward direction and one is negative direction. Likewise, what is the disadvantages of single linked list? So single linked list disadvantages, see, say for example, if you go for single linked list, the way in which you go, say you are searching for an element, the searching is going on in the forward direction. Say for example, we want to return back, then it is not possible in a single linked list. Also, you have more memory to waste. Memory is also much wasted. So if you go for double linked list also, you are maintaining more memory. But what is that? For that cost given to memory, the idea is worth of here. But here it is not so. So that is the idea. So why is a double linked list is more common than a single linked list? So double linked list is a two-way traversal. See, either way you can go. So normally what do you prefer? So if you have flexibility of going this side or that side, so what do you prefer? You need your independence. So you will prefer to roam around any place, right? Likewise, so here those you have links in both the directions. So both directions the place is missing. In what situation would you use the linked list, double linked list? So it depends on the situation. You can choose based on the things. So wherever you need a very faster performance, faster retrieval, and more effective operations, so you can go for double linked list rather than single linked list. So how do you implement a double linked list? Double linked list is a type of data structure that is made up of nodes. So it is made up of nodes that are created using a self. That is the structure node. We are created self. So that is the normal. Even single linked list is also created like this. And here, the important thing you need to remember is when you are creating a node, this node should contain three parts. One is a data part. Yeah, it is given here. One is a data part. Another one is previous address and the next address. So this you should remember. Previous address as well as the next address. So you should remember. You have to have a clear-cut idea about you need to have this stuff. So you have a data field and you have a next address field and you have a previous address field. So this is what when you implement double linked list. So here also insertion at the beginning, insertion at the end, insertion at any location. So insertion at the beginning, see. So this is already available list. Here you are going to insert. So what is that? So this is omitted and this is omitted and based on that some alternate adjustments have been done. Likewise, insertion at the end. So this is treated as null. So instead of treating as null, you make the pointer to forward. Whenever you make a pointer to a forward to your node, then immediately a backward pointer should come on arrows of it and point it to a node. And then the last bit should be made as null. The insertion at any locations, there is middle. You may say that it is a middle. So you have A node, B node, and you are inserting the item. The insert item should be inserted into the middle. So what is that? So this pointer has, these two pointers are deleted. One pointer is coming down and attaching here. Another pointer is coming down and attaching here. So one point is coming down and attaching here. Another pointer from there it is attaching. So whatever the points you have deleted, the same pointer may be replaced with some other pointers, provided the same structure is followed in case for insertion at any location. And operations of DLL, that is a deletion operation. So deletion also the same way. Deletion is beginning, deletion is end, deletion is any location. So let me go for the deletion. So if you go for deletion at the end, then the node that is pointed as head will be automatically deleted without any notice. So that head will now point to the next node or the first node. Now what is the deletion at the end? Likewise, the tail. The tail node is deleted and the tail node is made null. Tail node pointer made as null. insert at any location. So if you want to do any location thing, so what you can do is you can attach that to node. You can attach that to node. You have to omit that node in between. And after removing the pointer also, you will be, see, this pointer is deleted. So this pointer now we can point to the new node. And this pointer is deleted. This pointer is now point to the DS node. So this is what the head node of the when you are doing the operation for specific deletion. So implementation of DLL, so the same thing. So here you have two things you need to remember, that is two pointer. One is previous pointer, another one is the next pointer. That means whenever you add an element at the beginning, both the next pointer as well as previous pointer should be made as a null. So like this kind of statements, like when you go for implementing the concept insertion and deletion, the same thing here also, insertion at the beginning, void at the beginning, inside the beginning you need to do this thing, and void at the end, add end. So in the end, if you want to add it, so likewise you have to check whether the start equal null or not. If not null, you have to increment the data pointer, and if accordingly if you find the suitable position, then that element get added. So the most important thing is temp equal to next star, temp of next equal to star. Another one is insert, that is this insert is at any location. The any location can be, you have to check the position, whether that position is matching with your query or not. If the, your position is matching with the query, here you have to check the node value, right? And so you have to allocate a memory and that info field, you have to add the item and add that. So then the pointer adjustment has been made. Like a previous pointer, you have to attach to the last previous pointer. Next pointer should be attached to the next nodes, next next pointer. So like that, you have to make certain arrangements. So if you make certain arrangement, then the list is going to be correct. So this is what the idea is. So this is the deletion. Deletion at the middle. Here, see, the major difference is you need to think about the two address pointer. Point to the next and the previous. This is most important. So finally comes to the main model. The main model is carrying with several choices, 1, 2, 3, 4, and you have to choose any one choice. So now if you have chosen main method as the one source, so no, I may be left handicapped. So what you can do is you can go for something else, like a new data item, and that new data item will be used as such in the different choices. So when the choices is given like that, so accordingly the corresponding switch case can be executed. So case 1, case 2, case 3, so what the specific operation is. So when that specific method is called, say for example add end is called, add at beginning is called, and insert is called, and display is called. So according to that, the different methods have been called. So what is the advantages? This is, when you compare with the SLL, DLL is having enormous advantages. Yeah, DLL can be traversed in both the forward and backward direction. Deletion operation in DLL is more efficient if the pointer need to be the, so you see, the DLL is more advantageous when compared with the SSL. So only disadvantage is it needs some extra space. It needs extra space because of the too much of pointers. And the double English has been used in many of the day-to-day life. Say for example, when you are opening the browser, you have the next button, right? So this is one of the application link list. And in the Word, you have one of the browser like control Z. So you will be asking that, what is the thing that you told in the morning, you told in the afternoon, what is it? So that kind of stuff will be reduced when you have the redo and undo operations. Those things, and the collection of online games. So if you want to deal with the collection of deck of cards. So all these steps are applications of doubly linked list in a real life. I think the circular linked list we will discuss in another 15 minutes. So let us close the session up to this, and then we will resume back.
So okay, next class.